some trouble in the early game if they are not very, very careful. There's good setup, you know, both in bot and top for the Nidalee, especially post six, the Ash Arrows.
One, if they can shake this off, and it's going to be a late invade that'll be spotted by Perks as he walks away, but Yankos wants this camp. Will not land the javelin.
Looks like they're just going to fight for this. So we'll see if Jensen as well as Caps are actually going to move down. But Nice Spear does land. And I mean, I don't know how heavily they want to commit. I think in a drawn out fight, it should go the way of TL. But they're getting poked down. And this is going to come down to a smite fight, looks like.
Flash stun! They've got the combo! Yankos is not going to be rendered. The heal comes down in time. The flash auto is first blood for Tactical, and a red buff for Broxah. Team Liquid got...
And look at the camp difference. I mean, you've got the 5-farm lead for Jensen in mid, but Broxah now, speaking of a fight in the mid lane, though, CoreJJ dropping low, has the punch for the shield if he needs it. They'll jump forward. Big punch. Shockwave onto three. Yankos is burning down. Team Liquid with their second kill, and they're going to grab it on the Jensen. Ulti in for impact. Force the flash away from Yankos, and Team Liquid... up 800 gold.
Entire turret, and you know, based on the gold pre-herald, you know, you would say it's going in the favor of Tactical. Tactical is actually up 2 levels on Perks right now. That's the other into Tactical directly. That being said, G2 may just want to try to break out from the laning phase. They are such a strong macro team. They play the map incredibly well. And maybe they are just relying on, you know, based on the straight up golden experience, it's not bad for TL at all.
It's a 2,000 gold lead. I mean, golden XP, you can see Tactical and Jensen lead the charts, and it's not close. I mean, Tactical's got 1,400 gold over anyone on the G2 side. There's the cross-map play. TL stepping up. It's somewhat G2 dropping the ball here. And as you mentioned before, yes, I want to see the mid-game actually play out. But so far, we're basically waiting on Ash Engage and Mickey X for the other combos to get stuff going.
I mean, TL is looking fantastic so far. And I mean, I think that G2 has had to take a slower-paced game because of how bad the level 1 went, right?
Yeah.
They got the first blood kill, you know, over onto Yankos. Broxah has been taking away camps from Yankos as well. They're going to the engage now out of Jensen.
What a play out of Mickey. The dunk back is not going to be enough. He gets the kill, he gets the money, and he's going to walk right back out. Look at the combo. Look at the freaking damage. Beautiful out of Caps. And
see this next dragon. There was no really early dragon stacking that started from TL. So G2 is going to try to play the map, try to get themselves as much gold and experience as they possibly can before they are forced to fight, which is play devil's advocate. He may be thinking, all right, we have no AP threat. I've got to be able to kill frontline. You know, Bork Hurricane may be able to do a better job against the CoreJJ Impact duo. But Core looking to set up here on Perks.
Here's the flash engage. Shockwave going to miss. Let's Perks flash away. The auto's the punch. It's going to be maybe enough, but he autos. He's going to not quite stay alive. Live Bork could not be enough healing. Ignite takes him down. A kill in the mid lane and top, or sorry, mid lane outer should fall as well.
A great play from TL. Just and looking like they want to try to collapse potentially.
Looking for the play. They're going to have the whole squad grouped up together, but Ash is on the wrong side of the map. This is a 5-on-4 if TL can make their way in. Kalista ulti is up. Impact gets the slow. He can ult in for the extra slows as well.
That's
Tactical
far,
throws in CoreJJ. Stun lands the backside, gets a shield. That is a low health bar. Tactical gets shut down. Another kill to Mickey X. And here comes the re-engage. 5-on-4 for G2. Caps dives in. Will be shut down. Perks not there in range, and it means that Caps goes...
have the TP. Could be somewhat detrimental, but they have spotted Impact, and they're going to try to look for a pick.
Runs pretty quick, though. Still on Boots 1, but he's going to be headbutt pulled, and Wonders nearby. Finds himself a shield, walks away, but this is a 5v1. Impact ult, they're still going to be in range. They might find the slow. Flashes away, still gets stunned, still gets picked off. Perfect time for G2, but looks like TL wants to fight anyway. Core goes to dunk, only hits one, stuns in
Burks
the
in
AD
trouble.
Carry, burns a stopwatch. They're going to find the kill thanks to Jensen. Re-engage still good. G2 knocks down the Team Liquid support. The chase is still in. Mickey X running a bit low. The flash stun on Tactical. QSS keeps him alive. Flashes in for the auto. Ren finds it, but he's traded back all the same. Caps now fighting Brox. Another kill comes in for Jensen, and the chase is still on. Yankos dangerously low. Q is going to land, and Jensen finds his third kill of the fight. And Team Liquid take
there from CoreJJ and Jensen lining it up to catch Perks in that shockwave to take him down, put themselves to sole point here. Jensen now in a position to carry
4 minutes from Infernal Soul, and he's 5-1-2 with a 12 stack Magi.
He's having an incredible game, and internationally he has been good. You know, regionally it's always the discussion between him and Bjergsen, and Bjergsen has kind of gotten more done there, but he is looking incredible in this game. Impact may be in some trouble here. G2 trying to collapse once again.
But he's surviving, honestly.
If you show, TL could actually do Baron. And he's actually just straight up beating Wonder in this 1v1 right now.
holding the ult. He's going to put the storm down, and now how much more is going to happen as he jumps in for this
Jensen's
fight?
Coming.
He's running low on health, and here comes Jensen. He's going to go for the kill first. The shields can come after. Let him die. It's a trade of one for one. Mid laners both getting kills, and now another battle in the bottom river.
Too.
Mickey's in a bad spot. He's running, but Phase Rush gets him pretty far away. Jensen finds himself the one-on-one, and Mickey is running out of time. The headbutt backwards won't do too terribly much. Nice sidestep there for Broxa. The dunk can help guarantee it. And finally, end of the line comes through, and Core JJ finds himself his second kill. Team Liquid, 3-1 long term.
Will they go to Baron, though? Because TPs are up for both of the G2. So Team Liquid are making the call to go for it right now. Wonder TPing in the mid lane.
Yep.
G2 will challenge.
Make or break moment for G2. They cannot afford to lose this fight and the Baron thereafter. Teleports coming in all across the board. This is the battle, and Mickey can't be a part of it. Stun up perks. Brin's QSS flash in for Core, finds a stun, but cannot get more. G2 get the kill.
They trade one teleport for two. So Wonder and Caps both going to be down on the teleport. And we'll see if TL can make anything from that in a while. But Broxa, looking like he's caught out.
He is in danger. Great flash gets away from the pulverize.
Arrow.
But here comes the arrow. Not going to step this one either. Will get away. Here comes the shield. Here comes the re-engage. Caps getting low. Has to kite away. Jensen, of course, in range for most of this one. And be careful because Mickey's coming as well. He's coming for the play. He's going to find the headbutt. Going to find the pull. Not going to find much more than the arrow. Shockwave makes Jensen go godlike. And Impact's back in there as well. Not sure you're going to find this one. Yanko's kites away. A double kill yet again for Jensen. And the re-engage looking for more. Core JJ, no ulti just yet, but they do have Kalista for the follow-through. Runs in. Finds the stun. Here comes round number two.
They're all dead.
Kill number three. And kill number four. Baron is going to be easy. And Wonder may have won top lane, but he's not going to win the 1v.
Against it, looking like they are very close to being dealt their first loss here at Worlds 2020, and Team Liquid coming alive when they need it.
Not willing to give up this control. They are the most tenacious team I have ever seen come out of Europe. They will take battles that look bad
the flank
and
from
make
Mickey
them
Wonder.
Look good. Wonder, a big deal. Mickey here as well. Here comes the play. Can they secure the soul? Smite comes through, they grab it. Here comes the engage. Big stun comes across. Dunk back.
Perks isn't
they
in the
shut
fight.
Down Orianna. Do they have enough for the rest of it? Wonder will drop down as well. Two for one so far, and Mickey X is on the run. A double kill for Broxa, a headbutt to a minion. Surely he cannot survive this one. Team Liquid claim the soul, and they win the fight 4-1.
Huge for a team. And they're at the very least going to be able to secure one inhibitor.
Versus around, going to find the slow. Tio will cheat up to go for the inhib itself. They'll claim that. They'll run back as fast as they can. Respawns are coming. Teleports won't be up for a flank play.
If he hits a full combo on pretty much anyone, they're just gone, besides maybe an Alistar with ultimate up. So it is incredibly difficult to team fight here for G2, and the Baron buff is making things, you know, even tougher.
Just part of the mid wave says, okay, that's going to be yours, Wonder. Instead, we got to save our Nexus turrets, and here comes the top lane wave. You got about 3 seconds to show up, and it's indeed going to be the retreat. G2 played as patiently as they can. Team Liquid waited it out. Once the minions are there, the sixth man guarantees that siege is easy.
They're
and
still
we start
super
again.
Spot, so it's tough now, because if TL go for this, Perks isn't here, and they're going to go for the dive.
They go now, they dunk, Core is in. He cannot be pulled back in time because the threat on the back line. It's 1-0, and Mickey bought so much space, but he may lose his life for it. The ulti's going to time out soon, and there's not going to be another headbutt in time. He will drop it to 1-1, a trade of supports, but the wave means the team is sent back and that TL can try again.
And critically, Caps has no flash now. They're going to dive onto Perks.
Dunk turns off the turret. Perks going to get away with the QSS. Impact getting low, gets the shields to stay alive. And now the inhibitor is laid bare, and Tia will knock this one down. Baron respawns in 40 seconds, with supports respawning in 10. Should be an easy reset and a setup again for this top river. From it being that, but it was in fog. He couldn't have known any better. End of the day, TL get most members back, but they have not recalled, refreshed their health, refreshed their mana, or shopped since that siege.
Oh, and Mickey over the wall here could go for a big play. If he gets vision, he sees tactical now.
Gets the headbutt, pulverize, QSS running away, gonna stay alive, and the arrow gonna be tanked up by Core JJ. Mickey goes for the game winner, but it's not gonna be enough. Here come the re-engage, though. Wonder wants in, looking for the re-engage now. Onto Broxa. He's squishy, he'll be stunned. He gets the shield, though, and stays alive. But look at the health bars on TL. Four of the five are below half HP.
Here comes Impact.
Tries. Gets the stun. Mickey back in there as well. But Tactical gonna find one. Gonna find two. He's gonna lose his support, but he is still alive. Kill number three comes across. The dunk
over
the top. And if I learned anything from Worlds, that G2 or the LEC cannot beat play-in teams. Yankos on the way out. Impact on the chase. Minions in the bot side. And Team Liquid, they're not TPing in the base until now. Now they show up to knock down the turrets. And it's Yankos against the world. And I don't think he can do it. Jensen, he is 10-2.
2 and 10. The turrets will fall, and Team Liquid will find their first win of the group stage, knocking out the LEC sweethearts of G2 and getting a taste of revenge from MSI 2019.
And what a game from Team Liquid here. Such a big win.